How's it going, everybody? My name is Wes Davies, and welcome back to my channel. This is actually a video that I've been meaning to make for a while now. I think late last year, November or December, I actually hit 100,000 subscribers on this YouTube channel. I absolutely cannot believe it, and I can't thank you guys enough for subscribing to my channel and for continuing to watch these videos week after week. Thank you so much. And as you know, once you hit that 100,000 subscriber milestone, YouTube will actually send you a very special award. I've been waiting for this for, I guess, over 3 years, ever since I started my YouTube channel. I can't believe it's finally here. It came in the mail a few days ago, so I am so excited to open this on camera and show you guys exactly what's inside. So I think the purpose of this video today is to kind of go back to the early days when I first started my YouTube channel and kind of talk a little bit about my motivations. And perhaps if you're an up-and-coming or subscribing YouTuber, maybe I can offer some advice, talk about some of the challenges that I overcame when I was first starting out. So I'm just going to put this to the side for now. I will definitely open that in a few minutes. So I suppose when I think about why I started my YouTube channel, well, this was back in 2017. I was back home in Canada, living in Ottawa, Canada. I was working at a job that I didn't really love. And to be honest, the winters were kind of starting to get to me. Back in that part of the country, winters can last 6-7 months, and it is some of the coldest weather you've ever seen, minus 20 degrees, 25 degrees. Those were some pretty challenging times for me. I think at the time, I was just feeling a little bit, perhaps, directionless. I didn't have as much motivation as I wanted to, and I just wasn't quite sure where my life was heading next. Outside of work, I've always been very passionate about the arts. I've always had hobbies, particularly music. In high school and university, I was in several bands with some of my best friends and my brother, and we would write songs together and we would play shows all across Toronto, which is where we were living at the time. I can't believe looking back at that old footage of us playing at, you know, classic venues in Toronto. We looked so young back then. I can't believe that was more than 10 years ago now, but I'm still really happy that we have all those old tapes and footage. And actually, at one point we won a Battle of the Band contest, and first prize was that we got to go to a professional recording studio and record a 5-song album. I think if you look hard enough on the internet, you might be able to dig up that old album. Maybe I'll even share that link on my Patreon channel, and maybe in the future I'll go through what that journey was like. So besides music, I also eventually found that I had a passion for writing. I've always been an avid reader. I love reading science fiction books in particular. So around that time, 2013 or 2014, I started typing away at my keyboard, and 6, 7, 8 months later, I can't remember how long it took, I eventually wrote my first novel. This is called Binary Cycle. I was going by my old pen name, WJ Davies, and Amazon lets you publish these, or self-publish, I should say, and this is for sale right now. You can go and buy this book on Amazon. I was so proud of myself when I finished writing this book, and I immediately started writing a few more books, short stories, and I think this is the last book that I wrote. This massive book called Dark Frontier. I think I will have to make a YouTube video about my little writing career at another time. But as I said, I've always been passionate about the arts, about writing, about music. So I suppose this kind of journey into YouTube might be just a natural progression. So at the time when I was working at a pharmacy in Ottawa, I decided to start a YouTube channel. I had recently stumbled across a couple of channels online that really piqued my interest. They were actually travel vlogging channels. So I saw this one guy, Lost LeBlanc. He was traveling all over the Philippines and Thailand, Indonesia, Malaysia, and as far as I could tell, making YouTube videos was his full-time job. As soon as I realized that was a possibility, I was instantly hooked. I became obsessed. At that point, I saved up my money for a couple of months, and I bought this. This is basically my first YouTube camera. This is a GoPro Hero 4, and I was just so excited about making these YouTube videos that I could just upload to one of the biggest and most popular websites in the world, which of course is YouTube. I have to say, I got pretty obsessed with this whole YouTube thing, and eventually I did quit my job in Ottawa with the intention of moving to British Columbia to go see my brother and go live with him for 3 months. So I bought my plane ticket, and before I knew it, I was on a plane heading to British Columbia. I had an absolutely wonderful time out there, living with my brother in his van, traveling around the province of British Columbia. I worked on an organic farm for more than 6 weeks, filming all the time. I always had this thing in my pocket. And if you scroll back on my YouTube page far enough, you can actually go back and watch those initial GoPro videos.
It's just really funny the way life happens sometimes. I'm really grateful for this experience. If I hadn't actually made that conscious effort, I'd be sitting at a desk at a pharmacy right now, and none of this would be happening to me. It's just the power of believing in yourself and believing that you have the power to change your own reality.
I would say out in BC, I did a lot of soul searching. I really wanted to change the direction of my life. I wanted to do something that excited me, that filled me with passion and joy. So I actually won a video contest. Some of the footage that I took on the organic farm, I submitted it to a contest, and believe it or not, I came in first place. I couldn't believe it, and I won $1,000. So with that money, I used it to buy a plane ticket to Taiwan. So once again, I found myself in an airplane heading to a strange new world with a camera in my pocket and all my belongings on my back. Like most foreigners in Taiwan, I started off teaching English. And actually, I really, really enjoyed that job. I thought my kids were great, and I really enjoyed seeing their progress from day to day as I tried to teach them as much English as I could. That job is really, really fulfilling. I definitely just loved seeing my kids. I think they loved seeing me. You know, we had a really good relationship in the classroom. Yeah, I would highly recommend teaching English for anyone who wants to take that step outside of their comfort zone, try something new, and maybe even live in a different country. Of course, my passion for YouTube did not diminish. I saved up my money yet again for a bigger camera. This time it was the Canon 80D. I bought a microphone, a light, a tripod, everything that I needed to start what I would consider a more professional YouTube channel. And once again, I used all of my free time. I would go out on the weekends, try to explore as much of Taiwan as I could. I would wake up early and edit videos. I would edit videos when I came home from work. I just put so much time and effort into my YouTube channel, and I hope it paid off. I think it paid off, but I was just so excited about releasing these videos week after week. And then before I knew it, I think it was a video I was exploring the Fengshan traditional market, and suddenly that video started to take off a little bit. I think it got 400 or 500 views in the first week, which was a lot more views than my 40 or 50 views that my other videos had been getting up to that point. And then suddenly Alan from Life in Taiwan, I saw that he shared my YouTube page on his community tab to his followers. And that was really the first time that I saw a whole bunch of new people coming into my channel at once. I think I went from about 400 subscribers to over 1,000 in the course of several days. So if you're watching this, thank you so much, Alan, for giving me that initial boost here in Taiwan. After that, I guess that's the point when many of you started following this journey. I went from 1,000 to 10,000 and eventually to 50,000. I started meeting all those great YouTubers, and it's just been kind of steadily growing ever since. And once again, thank you guys so much for watching, especially the initial few thousand viewers. I can't thank you enough. So I think it's time to officially open the box. It basically looks like a big, heavy, black pizza box. The best pizza box that I've ever had delivered to my front door. So right away I can see there's this really nice felt mat, and there is a letter from the president of YouTube. This is so exciting. It says, "Do you remember your first subscriber, your 100th, or your 1,000th subscriber? Chances are you do, and we know that you'll definitely remember your 100,000th subscriber." Here is the main attraction here. I can't believe it. Honestly, I've been waiting for this moment. As I said, basically for 3 years or ever since I started my channel. Honestly, when you have 100 or 500 subscribers, 100,000 seems so far away, but you know, if you work hard enough, if you're motivated enough, if you spend enough time doing something, then usually some kind of success will surely follow. So here it is, presented to Wes Davies for passing 100,000 subscribers, YouTube. I'm just so happy to be holding this in my hands. So once again, thank you everybody so much for following me on this journey, and for being part of this with me. I wouldn't be holding this award in my hands if it wasn't for you. Thank you. Now, generally when I hit these milestones on YouTube, I generally like to do a little bit of a challenge. So I think 10,000, we ate stinky tofu. 50,000, Lucas and I, we ate some incredibly spicy ice cream. And today I wanted to do something a little bit similar. I found these noodles in the grocery store and I've heard about them. I've seen other YouTubers eat this. This is 2x Korean spicy ramen and apparently they are no joke. So I thought maybe I would just grab one of these packages and try some out for you, kind of as part of my 100,000 subscriber challenge. Okay, so while I'm waiting for the noodles to cook, I think this is a great opportunity to say thank you to NordVPN for sponsoring this video and for continuing to support my channel. I really, really appreciate that. So for those of you who are not sure what a VPN is, it's a virtual private network. And these days, so much of our life is lived online, on the computer, on our phones. And one thing that I think is more important than ever is to actually be able to protect your personal information when you're online. There's so much that we do online: emails, passwords, credit cards, your browsing history. There is so much that you want protected. And with NordVPN, all data that you send and receive online is transmitted directly through an encrypted channel. So in this way, no one can steal or even look at your private information. I've been using NordVPN now for I think 2 or 3 months now, and what I love about it the most is it's so easy to use. You just download the app onto your computer or on your phone, you load it up, and there's a quick connect button, and as soon as you hit that, you can rest assured that all of your personal data is encrypted and protected. As great as all that stuff is, for me, what I love most about NordVPN is what I can do with it in terms of streaming services. I'm actually trying to brush up on my French. I learned it all through school, but I haven't touched it in many, many years. So what I've been doing is I've just been connecting to France right through NordVPN. And then when I refresh my Netflix, suddenly I've got all these great French TV shows and movies that I wasn't able to see before. Luckily, right now, NordVPN is running a very special promo. For, I think, less than 100 NT per month, you can sign up for a 2-year plan and get 70% off of your final order. Plus, you will get an additional 1 month totally for free. So all you have to do is go to nordvpn.com/WesDavies. I will put all the links down below. Check it out for yourself. There's tons of great information on their website. Just make sure you use my promo code WesDavies. Thank you so much, NordVPN, for continuing to support my channel. For everyone else, go check out the link. And I think my noodles are ready. I'm gonna go check it out. Okay, this looks incredibly spicy. So the broth is just pure red. Wow, I can almost feel it in my eyes actually, in the back of my throat. I haven't even tasted it yet. So this is for 100,000 subscribers, guys. Thank you so much, and I suppose, wish me luck. Just gonna try the broth first. Oh my gosh, yeah. Woo, oh dear, that is spicy. Lucas, when you hit 100,000, I'm bringing a bowl of this to your house. Let's try the noodles here. They're very hot. Okay, it just hits the back of your throat. Oh, now my lips are numbing. I can't really feel my mouth anymore. And my eyes are blurring. Just fight through the pain. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that was interesting or educational. Oh yeah, it's really hitting me now. Thank you guys so much. Thank you, YouTube. I'm gonna keep making videos for you guys. It's getting up into my brain now. Love you so much, really appreciate you. Thank you. See you next time. I'm gonna try to enjoy this. Bye-bye.